Hey guys, it's Harshit Yami. Today I'm back with another short tutorial on how we can make this sliding effect in Figma using the Smart Animate feature, obviously. So I'm talking about this one, not the background one. The one where you can see that the text slides in into the background, you know, kind of phases in, just like here. And it's all handled while the user is scrolling through the page. So to do that, that's something that I have arranged, just a simple background, so the tutorial is aesthetic enough. And then we have like three taglines right here. I'm gonna just make it bigger and make the image more blended into the background so we can see the text. Now it's just too huge, I think. 45 pixels would be enough. Now, what should we do? So, first of all, you have to know one thing. That what is happening over here is how we can handle it in Figma. First of all, you have to like understand how Figma works. So whatever it is, it's going inside, I mean not on the website, on Figma. What is happening here is that these texts are going out or in from a mask, okay? And we have already covered a video where I have taught you guys how to make or use masks. Now for this one too, we are going to use mask, but the technique for that mask is going to be a bit different. How it's going to be, so let's jump into it. Again, a quick recap. To make a simple mask, if I want this object to be masked under this one, I would have to place it on top of it and then select both of them and hit this cute button right here, and you can see that this one is masked inside the other one, the one at the behind. So what we want to make sure is that the background, that the box that we are going to use as a mask for these three headlines is going to be at the back of these three fonts, and then select these three and with the rectangle, obviously, and then press the mask button, and you can see that the masking is done. But you can see if I use this mask right here, you can see that this is going to be an edgy look, right? It's not going like how we intend it to. You can see in here it comes and appears from the mask version really smoothly. And how can we do that? So in order to do that, we are going to select our rectangle, and we can see that it's filled with a color, but a solid color. Now, for masks, we know that the color that is filled is the actual area through which we can see the text or anything that lies under or over that mask. So if I change this, one thing to make sure that I have selected the mask object itself, the rectangle that we had used to create the mask, and now I'm going to change it to linear. And now you can see, give me a sec, I'm gonna duplicate the gradient on the next side too. And now you can see that the mid part of that particular rectangle is solid with 100% opacity, and for the either parts, the top and the bottom, we are using 0% opacity of that linear background. And that's it. Now you can see I'm gonna make a group for these texts, and now if I scroll through, right now I'm not using a smart animate or anything of the feature that we have been provided from Figma on the prototype level, but it's just a demonstration that I'm using right now in the Figma itself. So if I scroll through now, you can see that it goes out and goes in quite smoothly into the background. You can play with the linear color, obviously, quite easily, but that was the major trick. Now, to make it a prototype, what we will have to do is take it outside from your frame, obviously, set your text in the center, and then make the whole rectangle itself. Okay, so there is like a hawker outside selling some ice cream, so I'm gonna pause this video for a bit and then we can continue when he's gone. So yeah, sorry. Alright, now to do that, we are gonna have to make it whole as a component, and to do that we are going to press this button. Now that is the first frame, obviously. Now we need a variant as a second variant, and obviously we're gonna need a third one because there are like three slides in it. So in the second variant, what we are gonna do is select the group and scroll it to somewhere around here where you can see that the object at the top and the bottom are almost in that frame. And then for the third one, I'm gonna select the group of text and arrange it in a way that the text is in the middle of that gradient that we had made. And that's it. Now the last part, we're going to prototype and select this one. Right now I'm gonna make the trigger a click, just so we can, you know, scroll through easily and on my command. And make sure that you have chosen the Smart Animate, because it won't work unless you have selected this one. And again, when we are on this variant, we are going to click on it again to go to the third one, and again the Smart Animate would be in effect, and change it to 500 microseconds because we do want to see what's happening. Alright, and that's, I think that's enough. Now I'm gonna copy the first one and paste it into our frame, center it, and that's it. Now I'm gonna hit the play button and let's see what do we have in the prototype. Now as you can see, we have the background and the text at the top, and if we click on it, it is working perfectly as we wanted it to. Now to make it into a dragging section or a scroll, you all know that we will have to change it to from on click to on drag, and that's it. That would be it. So thanks guys for watching it. Hope you guys enjoy it, and you can use the same method to make a horizontal slider. If you want to know how to do that, I'm gonna make another video next about a horizontal slider, that where objects or slides can, you know, come in and go out in the same manner or fashion as we have seen over here. But for this one, that's it. So yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe. See ya.